Hello.
Molly!
Molly wants to
Stop
be on
that.
The show.
No, she's bitching at the people out in the hallway. And I'm hearing feedback.
You shouldn't be. It says there's a connection problem with you.
Yeah, my stream's muted and I can hear everything coming back.
You shouldn't be able to. The TV doesn't have a volume on. Hold on, let me call you back.
Okay.
Gameplay is choppy. Yeah, you know what? I see what it is. Guys, we're gonna try this again. Guys, it's actually coming through choppy on my XSplit as well. Hold on. How's that? How's that looking, guys? Yeah, still choppy? Okay, it actually looks better on my end now. Okay, there we go. Okay, good. That's all. I had to hit the magic button. So. Alright. Keeper of the time, are you ready?
I'm just waiting for the freaking page to reload for me.
Whoopsie daisy.
Refresh it.
Whoopsie daisy! It's good and broke now!
Yeah, way to go, Tom. Everything was working fine, and then you called, and everything just went to shit.
Pretty much. You sounded just like Corey when you said that. Which is about as the highest a compliment that I can pay you for being a woman on the internet.
Uh-huh.
Psychosis, sir. Thank you. Shiro, not HD, not yet. But the bitrate has gotten an increase. A considerable increase, because I found out that there is a setting within XSplit to figure out what server you need to send it to. And unbeknownst to me, there's actually one in Ashburn, which is where I live. How about that? So that makes all the difference in the world. So it's running at 1,000 kilobits per second, where in previous episodes it had been running about between 300 and 500 kilobits. And that's kilobits, not kilobytes. Now, I could stream it in 720p if I wanted to, but for this game, for the purposes of this episode, might be excessive overkill, because this game outputs at 480i. So.
Okay, everything with the exception of chat is loaded. Chat's being a whore right now.
Chat is being nasty. I actually had to pop it out to get it to work. So.
Well, it worked when I was first in here. There we go. Welcome to the chat room. Alright, you ready?
Camera's on. And soon it'll be on like Donkey Kong.
If it's on like Donkey Kong, how are you gonna beat Zelda?
I have no idea. I guess we'll make it up as we go along.
Hi, Blade Man. Hi, Tom and Kelly. That's from Nate.
Oh, hi, Nate Graves. The great Molly, Nate Graves from the Nate Graves podcast.
I have stilettos on. I have no problem putting my foot up your furry little bum.
Considering what you're telling me, what bum problem she was having the other night.
Okay, she's all washed up from that.
Oh, that's good to know.
You are just being a brat.
All right, guys, we only got 12 people in here. What's up with that? Tweet this ass. All right, ready?
And tell me when.
And here we go. Oops. Okay.
Wow. Off to green start. Here we go. Whoops.
Whoopsie daisy. No, I. It said start. When I hit start, it said start at Link's house. Start at the Death Mountain cave. Start at the sanctuary. And like, I thought I was in the dark world, but no, I was in the light world at Death Mountain when we last left our hero.
Like, either way, it always seems to start off with those three.
Only in the light world. Dark world, you always start at the top of the Pyramid of Power.
True enough. Apparently you went to the light world for something.
Yes, there was. I was doing a myriad of personal fetch quests because I realized there's no way I could have beaten the last dungeon in 20 minutes.
Hey, Mal. So that video that you showed me earlier, Mal, is that the new PS2 emulator that'll be running on the PS3 so we can actually play PS2 games?
I'm laughing. Because it's true, it needs it. I was actually going to do this funny video where I said, I've got this great PlayStation 2 emulator that has a pretty good homebrew community. In fact, Konami ported Metal Gear Solid 4 to it. But they don't make it anymore, which is sad.
Aw, that makes me sad, Malice. He said, no, it's for the PC. Because he showed me the video, Shadow Hearts 2 in HD.
I can play Shadow Hearts in HD.
Can you now?
Yeah, on my 20GB PS3 that's fully backward compatible.
In the HD, the graphics, they cleaned it up from the PS2.
That's what I'm saying. All that is doing is just taking it and broadcasting it in a higher resolution. That's the same thing that they've been doing with the HD collections that have been released, outside of, like, stabilizing the frame rate in the instance of Shadow of the Colossus. So that's essentially what the PS2, PS1 motion engine on the launch unit PS3s were doing. So,
well, unfortunately, I can't stream mine, or I can't do mine in HD anymore because my backwards.
Yeah, yours died, and that makes me very sad.
Yes, it makes me sad because now I can't play Shadow Hearts 2 in HD.
Yeah, no, that was seriously one of the best reasons to get a PS3 at launch, was to play the PS2 and PS1 games in a higher resolution. Mother of God! Jeez, those things do a lot of damage. Jeebus Christo! Okay, now I forgot what I'm supposed to throw into the ring of rocks. Is it just anything?
Just anything.
Something that's actually not going to explode.
Oh, and that ring of rocks? Use the mirror.
Oh, yeah, but there's like a. Oh wait, no, I know where it is.
You have to get up by the
ice cavern. Yeah.
Yeah, this one's just use the mirror, piece of heart.
Apparently I got it already because it's not here. That's funny. I don't remember coming this far south, but whatever. I may as well get that before I get in here. Mother of God. Man, the Zoras look positively terrifying in the Dark World. Big one-eyed monster.
So, water cyclops.
Yeah, pretty much. Cyclopsians. Although, funny enough,
that's Domino, if they actually would make an HD collection
of what?
Shadow Hearts. Because Domino's like, guess Kanan has to wait for Shadow Hearts HD collection.
Who owns the rights to that franchise now? Because Midway published the first two, so I don't know who.
And honestly, if by some miracle of God that they actually did make an HD collection for that, I would personally take out Shadow Hearts 3. I would light that on fire.
You better put that online. You get 1 million views.
Yeah, this is what I fucking think of Shadow Hearts 3. Pour a can of gasoline on it. Ooh, maybe get some sparklers going around it.
Gasoline. Oh, God.
Ella's Dreamscape went, Tom's milkshake brings all the boys to the yard.
No, thank you. Blah. Okay. Where's the
Molly going out on the balcony?
She wants to
get
end it all.
Doug. You have been an incredible pain in the ass this entire day.
Okay, seriously, where is that ring of rocks? Wait a minute. Was that up north by Zora's Falls?
Yes.
Oh goddammit, well, nope.
Ellis Dreamscape, be nice to the poor bitch Kanan. No, I have been nice, Ellis Dreamscape, but this dog likes to wake me at the ass crack of dawn by sitting and whining at the bed for a full half hour straight until I get up and feed her food. Yes, this dog has prepared meals for her. Her kibble is actually a snack, not real food for her, it's a snack. And then once she figures, oh, you've been up to feed me, now you should play with me. So she will sit and whine until I get up and do stuff with her. No, she doesn't want to cuddle Ella's dreamscape. She wants to be a pain in the ass.
Sounds like she's a
spoiled puppy.
Not
to mention that the fact that this morning I walked into the bathroom, nearly stepped into a puddle of pee because she decided instead of going on her little puppy pee pad, which she normally goes on, no problem, no, she decided to go and piss on the floor for no fucking reason when there was a fresh pad on the floor for her.
A little weird.
Yeah.
You remember how much
I think she's starting to get like social anxiety because my sister and her fiance haven't come back. Because, like I said, she's not using the bathroom like she should be, even though I've been taking her out for her walks. She's been an absolute
pain
in the ass. Huh?
How old is she?
I want to say 2 years old.
Oh, okay. Well, then there's absolutely no excuse for her behavior like that.
Domino, I've had worse with my cat, so don't even try and start the pissing match.
Get it? Pissing match?
Bad joke was bad.
Seriously, I don't remember how many rupees I'm supposed to throw in here. Big trouble! It's like, oh no, stop throwing rupees because it's bad luck if you keep doing it.
Aw, poor Lauren locked herself out of her apartment.
Quick, G1, send Lauren your power so she can overcome the lock.
Yeah, I just noticed the tweet. Locked out of your apartment is the new it place to be on Friday night.
I locked my car, locked myself out of my car 3 times in front of the store, back when I was a store manager, and I was locked out of the store, locked out of my car, couldn't get into my apartment. Worst thing ever.
Are you, like, running out and running back in?
What are you talking about?
For the fairy.
Yes.
You do realize if you just keep walking up to the fountain, it eventually triggers the same thing?
Oop.
Yeah, you don't have to exit and re-enter. You just have to kind of keep walking up to it, and eventually it triggers the thing again.
Oh, how about that? It was the second row? Yep, it's the second row. Okay.
Ella's dreamscape. I would send her my power, but I would rather send her a locksmith. I think that would be more helpful, no?
I think that would be. Today I will have big trouble. Don't you tell- oh, nope, gotta do it again. Yeah, I gotta wait longer. So it's like 100 is what I have to throw. Thirty-five, that's all? Jeebus, woman. I remember getting to a really weird number with her. Like, for the arrows, like, something like 60-something. Weird. I'll just throw all the rupees. Because chances are I'll have enough to at least get another blue potion. And then we'll go into dungeon number 5, which totally freaked me out when I was a kid. Like, the first time I was playing it, I got so frustrated with it, not as frustrated as dungeon 3, but enough frustrated that I actually went to dungeon 6 to get the cane to come back and do it. And yes, I'm eating on air. I'm having sun chips. How professional of me. Because, of course, as always, I couldn't get my ass together before the show started. Whoops. Meant to throw more than that, but whatever.
Ella's Dreamscape says, this is what happens when Lauren doesn't invest in the lockpick skill. Maybe that be a lesson to you all.
Lockpick. She wants to become the new master of unlocking.
Mouse says, Tom needs old man cane to handle the next dungeon.
Oh, dude. Not cool.
Don't forget to offer them some popsicles.
Yes. All the girls get popsicles.
I'm sorry, what?
All the girls get popsicles.
Yeah, I'm gonna pass.
Oh. Bomb womp.
Yeah, womp womp. Although, interestingly enough, there's a thing, there's an actual, like, cream that you can put down there to make your dick taste like creamsicle. It's actually called Dixicle.
That's amazing.
Damn right it is.
Well, yeah, because your comment the other day about milkshakes in general and men.
And for some reason, you're sounding really low to me.
Really low to you?
Yeah.
Hello?
Like, I'm having kind of a hard time hearing you. My volume's on max. Like, it sounds like you're kind of sitting away from the microphone.
Let me fix something.
Yeah, let's stream escape. Cock block! Get the fire rod. Dear God!
How's that?
That's better.
Sounds good. Okie dokie,
He goes, Laura Moore stuck outside of her house on Friday. I'm not surprised.
Aww. Aww, dude. Yeah, 40 arrows.
We're at 15 people.
More, it's a Friday night. Come on now. Come on now!
Well, Lauren can't because she's locked out.
Tell her to download the app on her smartphone.
Oh, yeah. Here, watch Tom's stream while you're waiting for someone to pick the lock.
Pretty much. All right, here we go. Melt. Flames will protect you. I can protect myself.
No, you can't. You're old and feeble.
Damn it. Nothing is over yet. So how's everybody's Friday night doing? Out there in Chatland and with you, Mistress Kanan, on the line.
Come here.
Come here. Meh. Oops. Oh god, these penguins. Jesus. That's right, S-A-D.
Dreamscape. Molly is the bane of Kelly's existence. Honestly, normally I like the dog, but today, actually the past few days, she has been just going out of her way to piss me off.
That's not good.
No.
It's quite bad.
Yeah. It's gotten to the point, like I said, she sits and she whines. Like, after she's gotten her food, she goes, she wolfs it down, and then she just sits and whines. And I mean, she will not stop. She will continuously sit and whine until you, like, play with her.
Oh.
And you can't just, you know, play with her for, like, a good 10, 15 minutes and be done. Nope. She wants you to play with her all the fucking time. And I said that wouldn't be so bad, except, you know, at 5 or 6 in the morning, I'd kind of like to sleep. Mm. So now I've kind of gotten to the point of having to trick her, where I have to go out, feed her, and when she actually goes to eat her food, I then close the door to my bedroom and put my headphones on so I don't hear her whining at the door.
Wait, you feed her in the middle of the night?
Morning.
Oh,
5,
sorry.
6 in the morning.
Oh, whoopsie-daisy. Damn it.
But if I was sleeping at 5 or 6 o'clock at night, then I really wouldn't be co-calming now, would I?
Yeah. So how is work?
I don't know, I haven't started yet.
I thought orientation was on Monday.
Yeah, but I said that they made the schedules, like, they make them 2 weeks in advance.
Oh.
So I have to wait a few weeks to actually put, like, James tried his best to talk to his boss, like, he explained the situation, like, look, you know, she really needs hours, like, she's really low on money.
Mm-hmm.
So she really, really would appreciate just even a couple hours here and there. So, but I have to wait for her to call or text me to let me know that, you know, Tom, don't listen to Kelly. What the hell, Criven?
What is this? I don't even.
I don't know.
Oh, speaking of I don't know, and
Dreamscape, he goes, then again, it doesn't take a lot to piss an Irish off. Actually, I taught driver's ed for 3 years, Dreamscape. I have more patience than you would think. And trust me, there were some really bad students.
Wa-pa-pa-pa. Oh, so, Caleb found me.
Don't mention that on live air. Dude.
Yeah, I know, I'm just saying.
Yep.
That's all I'm saying. Yay! Give me the key.
Man, yeah, Ina had to deal with a rowdy Link shell. She has patience.
Wow.
No, Dreamscape, it's not like working at the DMV. You're thinking of the actual examiners, the ones that actually take the people out for their tests.
Yeah. Dude, that's even more effective than using the sword. That's nuts. This guy, he's like, I'm gonna hit you. And I'm like, please don't.
That's okay, Dreamscape. But yeah, no, at the DMV, you have the examiners. They're the people that are hired to actually test you so you can get your license.
Mm-hmm.
I'm the person that actually teaches you how to handle the vehicle and proper driving techniques and such like that.
Dang it. You run! Oh gosh. Oh god, it hurts!
No, it doesn't. Man up, you pussy. Walk it off.
I'm trying to.
And knowing is half the battle.
G.I. Joe!
You do it.
Ow.
Oh my god. Actually, speaking of G.I. Joe, when I was doing some more laundry today,
yes.
I was reading a paper, and there goes your notification.
Yep.
Anyways, I found out that, one, they're making another G.I. Joe movie, but it's in the works to make another He-Man and the Masters of the Universe film.
Interesting.
And they're going to make a live-action Elf.
Yeah, I'm not too happy about that one. I think the time for that has passed by a long time.
I'm just like, please stop bastardizing my childhood.
Yeah. The thing that I'm actually more upset about for the whole thing is that the Masters of the Universe movie, depending on who it gets handed off to, could be something very good.
Alf,
there's no way that could be good. I'm just
you're
saying.
You're gonna have PETA in there going, "You are enforcing cat eating."
Yeah, what? Exactly. Yeah, that's.
PETA's gonna boycott Alf.
Oh, dude, they're gonna flip S. Crap, I think I trapped myself.
Way to go. Dur.
Yeah, because there's nowhere I can go from here without the big key.
Nice. Dolph Lundgren said he would like to be the king of Eternia in it.
That's well, he was He-Man in the original, so why not? Why not make a cameo appearance?
Domino, you forget, though. Tom's not that much older than me, so bastardizing his childhood is bastardizing my childhood.
Yeah, you don't want to do that, dude. You hurt one of us, you're going to hurt both of us. So, you know, as much as it pains for me to have to tell you guys that I like the same things that she did, too.
I'm 28, Ella Streamscape.
We're children of the 80s. Deal with it.
What the hell? Molly, oh my god. Did you, like, zombie that fucking lamb?
What?
Remember how I was all excited? Do you hear that?
You were all excited about what?
Remember how I said Molly killed the squeaky lamb?
Yes.
One that I wanted to kill? That I took pictures of
her
murder?
Oh, yeah. That was great.
She comes up to me with the lamb.
The remains of it?
And the squeaker still works.
Oh.
I thought I got rid of that thing. Oh, fucking zombie lamb.
Yeah, you were freaking me out. I thought, like, something else had happened, like the zombie apocalypse was really happening.
That's the case. I'm going and I'm purchasing a shotgun. Which you... No! You know what? Auntie's gonna take that lamb. She's gonna burn it and she's gonna toss it off the balcony. Yes, she is! It's gonna be like the 4th of July, except we're burning a fucking lamb.
This is a Canadian saying this, folks.
Oh, I'm sorry. Canada Day. We don't have the 4th of July.
Yes, you do. You have one every July.
I just...
You mean American Independence Day? Hi, Kanan.
Tom.
Hi.
If I could.
You would. You don't even have to finish the sentence. No. I just know you.
No. If I could, I would reach to this monitor, and I would choke you. And then I would find some little My Little Pony toy.
Yeah.
I would shove it down your fucking throat.
Hey.
Twilight Sparkle.
Make it Fluttershy so that way every time I yawn it's yay.
No. I like how I had to explain the hookshot to Shelby last night in this area.
Oh. It's like, what do I do? Where do I go?
Streamscape. Does Kanan have to choke a bitch? Well, Tom is quite the bitch. I may have to choke him.
Sometimes I sure can be.
Oh, you. Anyways, as I was trying to say before, you know, you decided
to be God damn it.
Is we have Canada Day, and then you guys have 4th of July, so it's pretty much the same.
Independence Day!
What the fuck ever? You guys blow up a chunk of your country.
Yes, we do, and it's awesome. Right. Oh, it's one of those fake cracks in the wall.
Shiro, I will pay Kelly just to let me see her doing that to Tom. Awesome! Wait, I could make a living off choking you if Shiro's willing to pay me every time.
You will pay you in rap dollars.
Fuck no, real money.
Rap dollars is better than real money.
No, it's not!
Yeah,
it's
it is!
It's only money! Going, rap dollars! No.
Rap dollars means, like, it's all, like, gangster bills, which means they're, like, untraceable, so you don't have to pay taxes on them.
So, in other words, they've probably stuffed down an assorted amount of G-strings.
There's definitely that's a possibility. You got the map that you don't need.
Kelly choking Tom must happen at SGC. There we go! Who's willing to pay money for me to choke Tom so I can send it to SGC?
Yeah, there you go. As you may have noticed, there's a donation button down below, so you can donate to the choking fund.
Not if they're not on the Twitch portion. If they're in the actual Screw Attack one, there's no donate button.
I guess I gotta figure out how to embed that next.
And SGC was just funded. Like, this Mal's like, we have independence from the British! Let's fucking blow up the land we have now!
Pretty much. Because, like, we actually talk about, like, Rocket's Red Glare in our national anthem. That's talking about Concreve's rocket pelting the side of Baltimore's harbor.
I do realize this.
Yeah! You get away from me. No, get away! Okay, I think? Maybe?
Honestly, I really, like, I was kind of hoping they would do Mario Party this week, because like I said, if they did Mario Party, just that alone would have pulled in a shit ton of money for SGC.
Well, I will say something that has happened this week that has not happened in any week prior to it.
What?
We are seeing more steady $100 donations per day. Like, we hit 47,000, and then we hit 48,000 within the same week. That didn't happen before.
No.
So.
Well, I said we're kind of down to the wire, but like, I actually mentioned it to Sam. Like I said, if they had probably done a Mario Party this week, I guarantee they could have brought in a lot more money, because like I said, people just come out of the woodworks for Mario Party.
Yeah.
And I know when they do the, it's at 49K now!
What?
Domino just put 49K.
Okay, see, there you go. Like I said, we're seeing a steady increase.
Psychosis,
oh,
I don't know why Shelby has antennae.
What?
Psychosis, like, Kanan, why does Shelby have antennae?
I don't know. Maybe because she wanted some? Damn,
no,
those staffos do a lot of damage.
You cannot have the demon lamb.
Lamzy is evil. The wolf.
Lamb chops, play along.
Oh no. This is the song that does
no,
it.
No! No. I will murder you. I will fucking shank you.
You love it. You know you did.
No!
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Ha! Karma! Kanan says no. Beans, no! Malice, I will fucking murder you. I will somehow invade you in Dark Souls, and I will shank you.
I will end you! You are nothing!
Donate to SGC to see Kelly shank Tom.
There you go. On stage with a bloody knife. So she can see me get tetanus.
So in other words, I should definitely dress up as Alice then
yes.
for that.
Yes, people want to see you dress up as Alice anyway. May as well give them a reason!
Honest to God, I think that's what people expect of me now. Is like, if they see
do.
Me, they expect me to dress as Alice.
Oh, this is a trap room. There's nothing in here. God damn it. Went through all that trouble to come back in here. It's a trap room. Whatever.
Ben, really hope this stream isn't used as evidence against Kanan.
Did I hear the Trollolopopo?
No, that was her whining.
Oh, Molly. You run! Oh.
American McGee's Alice Madness Returns, Alice Jackal. Not from Resident Evil.
Yeah,
and
no.
Dreamscape's like, I just assumed Kanan was Alice.
Well, the resemblance is rather uncanny.
Yeah, although I'd have to dye my hair actually a darker shade of brown.
I'm okay with that.
Yeah, you would.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Mega Silver!
Hey, welcome to the big show.
Mal, I will fucking end you.
Mal, I will end you! Damn it. Oh, I have the big key this time. Okay, cool.
Yes, Psychosis Alice Madness. And Tom has seen pictures of me.
Yes.
And my hair is actually almost long enough to pull it off without having to use a wig.
Yes.
I would just have to straight iron my hair. Mal, love you too, Kanan. Aw, that's friendship right there, when you threaten to shank one another in Dark Souls. That's scary, Kelly.
Is it, or is it just natural? Damn it.
I can't help it. I have natural red pigmentation, I'm part Irish. Of course I have a violent tendency. I was raised in a fucking port city. Cursing is my second language.
It has a proficiency in cursing.
No, Kriven, I've had, like, well, Tom's on my Facebook, so he's seen my pictures, plus
yes.
I have put some pictures on Twitter.
Yes. Lovely, lovely pictures, I might add.
Apparently, Blayman says OnLive was in some serious trouble.
OnLive has filed bankruptcy. We don't know if it's chapter 9, 11, or 13. It's bad times. I really do think that service, along with Gaikai, is about 10 years too early. Because the only way that kind of cloud gaming will work is when internet connectivity is as readily as available as a connection to electricity. So, that being said, I would not be surprised if you hear Microsoft or Nintendo putting a bid in on them once their bankruptcy protection gets kicked in. Because Sony bought Gaikai.
Blayman already said it is going to continue under new service.
Is it? Okay, I'm pretty sure.
And Dreamscape goes, she lies! She has no face! She's HAL 2000!
Oh god, don't say that. That I don't know what face I was looking at, and that's terrifying. My
like,
face!
I was just gonna say, I'm like hexadecimal. I can just swap out the face.
Don't say that.
Fucking love hexadecimal.
Yeah, but that freaked me out as a child because every other like camera angle, her facial expression would change, and I was like, what the crap's going on here? I didn't get it for the longest time. Oh, for fuck's sake.
Nate Graves. So Kelly's a supercomputer that can play Third Strike and Dark Souls. Seems
like pretty much.
You stop whining. I am not giving you the squeaky toy. No. Do you hear this?
Molly.
Are you going to complain to the internet? Hold on a second. Want to complain to the internet?
What? Yeah. What breed is Molly again?
She's a Shih Tzu. She's...
I need to get on the other side now.
She is a Shih Tzu poodle.
Gotcha.
Mal, Kanan is hexadecimal. Kanan, hand me this ChamWow. Yeah, you, do you actually hear her in the background?
I heard you. I thought I saw you post recently that you were looking to get a ShamWow.
Not look. Mal showed me the video of Shadow Hearts 2 in HD.
Oh, so you needed a ShamWow.
Yeah, okay.
Molly.
Molly. Oh, goddammit.
Are you gonna do the proper thing? Are you gonna complain on the internet?
Molly's gonna have gonna have one of those,
She's gonna wait 40 seconds, she's gonna get banned.
She's gonna wait 40 seconds, and then she's gonna get banned, and then she's gonna do an online petition. Cause you know, those always work on the internet.
Molly! My goodness! Come on up!
Auntie, just pet her, and maybe she'll be quiet.
Come on!
No. Yeah. Come on. Shh. No, Molly.
Molly, come on. You're getting tangled in Auntie's cords.
Yes, you are.
And you're literally just shaking. Yes. I know you want your squeaky lamp, but Auntie wants to burn it. Because it's evil, it tries out to get the wall. Yes, it does. Yes, it does. And you want to give kisses? Kiss? Nope.
Get off then.
Whoa.
No, she was on my lap and she's just like squirt.
No! I don't care! No! Ah.
Jesus!
She's complaining to the internet.
So this episode of Race to the Finish has been brought to you by the letter D for dog.
Mal's like, come to watch Tom play, stay for Kanan baby talk. And Psychosis says to you and I that he might be playing Man vs. Machine with Jared again, so he might not be in the chat.
That's fine. Whoops. Push that there.
Ella's dreamscape. Molly is now the first butthurt dog on the internet.
No. No!
Just give her the dog what she wants. I'm feeling sad for her.
No! She is a furry terrorist. You are! You are a furry little terrorist! No! I am not giving in to your furry demands.
No.
Shh! Molly. Hold on a second.
Molly, do you want a treat? Oh, magic word, magic word! Magic word!
Hold on one second, I'm gonna go give her a treat.
You go ahead and...
Oh yeah, no, I'm gonna put the headset down so you can hear this dog.
That's not a treat. Giggity. Oh, crap. Great, now I gotta fight this guy without the blue male. You know, if I had the Explodier... Oh well, that's fine. It's what happens. We'll just go back and get it.
God, that shit's nasty.
So I accidentally fought the boss before I got the blue mail.
Oh, way to go. Don't show it, Miss Kanan.
Yeah, so I'm gonna have to go back inside. Or I could skip it and keep going to get the red mail instead.
That's up to you.
Or does the game do the weird thing where it gives you the whichever mail you don't have first?
No, I have actually skipped the blue mail in its entirety because I got really pissed off with that dungeon when I was younger. Sure. You don't need the blue mail if you have skill.
But it's the completionist in me.
Played, man. You'll end up using a lot more blue potions, I bet.
This is true, and I don't even have enough money to buy one right now.
Shiro says, just like Captain Falcon, show me your moves, Tom!
Whoops. I'll show you moves.
No.
Oh, come on, Kanan, it'll be fun.
Yet no.
Last longer than 5 seconds.
Yay for you?
Yay for you, too!
Yeah, no, I'm gonna go solo. I don't feel like co-op.
Oh. See, I don't know what's funnier, the fact that she burned me like that, guys, or the analogy that she used.
Little column A, little column B.
Giggity, giggity, giggity.
Yeah, you can keep saying that, you ain't getting it.
What if I try really hard?
No.
At least I can use the mirror to GTFO real quick. Oh, for F's sake.
Alice Dreamscape Canon needs no co-pilot.
Giggity giggity goo. Fairies! Okay.
Sure, this is Tom. How many times are we gonna go through this? When Canon says no, it doesn't mean no. Or choke you until your face is turned rainbow colored? Yeah, but what? Shiplash solo, baby!
No, it's, yes means no, no means yes, yes means maybe, and we need to talk means you're getting dumped. That's the code.
I always hate when it's like, we need to talk. Fuck.
It's like, you know that the rest of the night's not gonna be what you want.
Nope. It's like, unless we need to talk is going to involve,
Like vacation plans or something like that, you know?
Fuck that. There's like barbecue wings, tequila, and a brand new game that I don't want to have a talk.
Pretty much.
Domino. No one said we need to talk when they dumped me. Now they probably just tossed you out in the garbage can, Domino.
Damn! God damn it.
Muda, I didn't give you the opening. Shiro did.
You said opening.
Yeah, and you ain't getting anywhere near my opening.
Damnation.
Yeah. Oh, my apologies, Domino. He's like, we don't have garbage over here.
It's rubbish. Like,
fucking anchor.
Here's one for you. Like the TVR, right, Domino?
Well,
he's either gonna think that's hysterical or he's gonna kill me. I don't think he's going to get mad at me, though, because some Russian bought the company a couple years ago.
It's Dreamscape. Call it whatever you want. It's shit.
Oh, god damn it.
Shiro. Really, Tom? Opening? That's the innuendo you're gonna go with? You can do better. Shiro, obviously you haven't been watching Tom's streams very much then, have you?
The whole gag, Shiro, is that I make a very lame advance towards her and she shuts me down. It's the formula. Now whether... Yeah. No, whoa! Because if
what?
I keep doing, like, clever advances to shutting me down, then it's not gonna be funny anymore. There's a procedure, there's a method to it.
No, actually, it would be funny if you came up with something clever.
Oh, really? Okay, well...
Yeah.
Oh, god damn it! Come on! Climb!
I mean,
go
I'm
down the stairs!
It's like, I'm doing some grade-A burns on shutting you down, and all I get is opening! Oh, yeah!
There! Jeebus! It should not have been that hard.
Alice Dreamscape. Tom Harvey, you watch your tongue. You are a married elephant? Fuck Dreamscape!
What is this? I'm a filly. What is this? Jeebus. Christo. There we go. Alright. Palette swap. Alright.
Criven. Hey, Tom,
solved.
How about you make advances towards me and let's see where it goes?
Criven, no. No. Just no. All of my no. Just no. No.
Now you know how I feel when you make really bad come-ons to me. Oh!
You!
Muda says, the comedy team of Tom and Kanan. Tommen. Or is Kime better? No, I don't want to go with Kime because I had a friend named Cameron.
Oh.
And no, his... No, his game name in 11 was K-A-I-M.
Oh, was it?
Yeah, like, well, that was his name for Cameron.
Whoopsie daisy.
Maybe Tom is a zebra?
A zebra? What?
Yeah, I miss Cameron too, Mel, and he's on my Facebook, and the little bastard, like, just every once in a blue moon, like, I think once a year, I'll get a random message from Cameron. Which, the funny thing about Cameron, Tom, is yes. His son's name is Kanan.
Yeah!
Yeah, it's spelt differently than how I spell mine. But that was the funny thing, was I met Cameron in college because of my best friend. When I met him, like, his girlfriend was already pregnant at the time, and he had just found out that I also played Final Fantasy XI, and when he found out my character name, he's like, "Aw, fucking hell!" And I go, "What?" He goes, "I'm naming my son Kanan! What the fuck?" And I was like, sorry, I had it longer.
You're his godmother.
Although, I was the only one of Cameron's friends that actually went to go and visit him when his son was
Isn't
down.
There a Dark World portal, like, right around here? Or is it on the other side of the river? You know what? Screw it, I'm just gonna go to the castle entrance. That'll do it. Fuck.
Shiro, wait. Is the zebra white with black stripes? Or black with white stripes?
Oh. Great questions. Questions that need answers. Write me out.
And now all I can think of is fucking Afro Circus.
Afro but Circus? Shelby... Yeah, Shelby ain't here right now, which is...
I don't know. I just love the fact that I trolled her with that, and she just got right quiet. She was... I can't believe you just did that. Although nothing beats the baby cannon last night. That was fucking brilliant.
Dude, we were talking about that for a while afterwards. That was amazing. And you know what? It's just confetti. Poof.
Oh, no, actually, I was thinking, too, on how to improve it. Because you know how normally, obviously, when a woman's giving birth, there's a doctor there to take the baby out.
Hey, guys, let's do a link to Craig's past.
Okay, anyways.
Because I need money.
You've got, the baby cannon, which we've, you know, the baby confetti cannon now, or party cannon. Instead of the doctor being there, what they should have is a giant target with a net behind it. So when the baby comes flying out, the mother can try and aim for the holes 10, 20, 50, or 100.
Through the uprights!
You sure a baby cannon? Yes, excellent idea! I thought so. I really hope she highlights that.
Oh, and... yeah. The both of us have been working on embracing our YouTube-ness a little bit more with stuff like that, so I'm pretty sure that's gonna show up on her channel before too long.
Blaven says, so what? Does the baby get a medal? I don't know if the baby should be getting the medal, or if it should be the mother for actually being able to, one, fire said child across the room, and two, to actually get it in a good...
Look at this. Magic takes more than one hit to kill the snakes, but the hookshot does them one shot. Draw your own conclusions, folks. Alright.
Now all I can think is, quick, fire the missiles!
Oh, those Russians. It is the end of the world, after all.
It's the French. Quick, fire the missiles!
Oh, whoops. I'm sorry, I was thinking of the other one. Ah, Motherland! And then, bees! They're tearing my flesh off!
The mother should get a trophy. Damn right she should. But apparently, Blaven doesn't like the baby cannon topic.
Who?
Blaven's like, please do topic!
Does it make you uncomfortable that we talk about vaginas?
Okay,
how do we get up there?
Dakosa says, guys, this is just great. My Steam says it's a problem with installation that I must reinstall. When did you actually install Steam originally?
3,000 years ago.
That made no sense.
3,000 years ago when Sigourney Weaver was still hot. Okay, I'm clearly...
Dreamscape, can't explain to me how babies are born. I no longer fear death thanks to her. That's right.
Wow.
You get pumped out of the baby cannon, then you can take anything.
Literally, anything. You dick.
I still would, like, pay great money to just see, like, some woman give birth and go, Kamehameha, and just fire that thing out.
She lives her life like a Kamehameha, gives it all, never gives up.
That or Big Bang Attack!
Woo!
I love Dragon Ball Z so much.
Yeah. Hell's Light. If we're not gonna call it, say, the Japanese name, which is Pachinko Sappo, at least call it by its direct translation, Hell's Light.
Final Flash.
Okay, that's gonna have a whole new meaning.
That's apparently when the husband peeks over the curtain.
Oh. You know, before the Rams had, right?
Blade Miss, but the launching of babies out of said vaginas that makes me uncomfortable. Kaioken! Kaio what? Kaio crap! That's what I thought. Mm-hmm.
Take this, now go away!
That's not a pizza! That's not a pizza at all!
Nope. Do you see, kids, the medallion that I just got? There's two in the game, there's three in the game, but you only need to get, two of them. The third one's completely extra. Kind of like in this game, like, you don't need to, well, you can use it as a weapon, but it's not required. The ice rod becomes very useful in a boss later in the game. It's not required to beat the game, though, just kind of like how the ice arrows are available, but not required to beat the game in Ocarina of Time. Although I do find it hilarious that one of the,
I like the fact that Blademan was uncomfortable with the talk about launching of babies, but here he's like, what if they were Super Saiyan while pushing?
Okay.
Double standards!
Kind of.
Don't you need the ice rod to beat the Turtle Rock boss?
Do you? Because I remember you could just, wail on it.
It helps.
Yeah, kind of like how you can use it to beat the second boss in the light world here, in the desert temple. It makes fighting those sandworms so much easier.
I just want it to be popular.
That's what I... No, I never said that.
I'm just wanting to get laid.
Pretty much. I mean, seriously, screw popularity. Then there's all sorts of new, like, responsibilities to get dumped on you, and you don't need that. So to speak.
Hey, Phantom X Dead, he's like, shit, I'm late.
Well, thank you for coming out, buddy. Tweet this S. Tweet.
Shiro said, I was in the hospital last Friday with a friend giving birth. For some reason, that reminded me of Goku turning Super Saiyan 3.
Yes, the
enhanced strength that comes from that. I could believe a going SS3.
Okay, there's supposed to be a thing. Okay.
Cool. Psychosis just said to us, he goes, Jared might stream our Man vs. Machine tonight, so sorry if you lose viewers.
Well, you know what? It's not like I can plan around him and he plans around me. We just do what we do. We just, you know, try not to step on each other. Mm-hmm. I'm small potatoes compared to him, so I don't take offense to that in the slightest.
Potatoes.
Potatoes are so good.
I know.
We're so Irish.
I know. But I don't care.
I don't care either.
And you can do so much with them.
I know.
It's just like, huh.
Twice baked.
One of the things that I, actually, now I'm sitting here going, I wonder if there's actually potatoes in the fridge. because, before they left, Slav got a bunch of potatoes, so I actually, like, washed a couple up and, you know, diced them to, like, little circular patties. And I cooked them in a fry pan with Montreal steak spice on them, and I shredded, cheddar over them.
Oh, nice. That sounded like an orgasm in your mouth.
Mmm.
Oh, just missed it.
No, Muda, don't ever say that again. Ellis Dreamscape. I'm gonna stay with Tom and Ken, thank you very much. They nurture the child in me.
Glad that we could do that for you.
Aww. and I'm sorry if I mispronounced it, but Scroas, he's like, seriously guys, why are you talking about food? I can't afford it right now.
Oh, that's sad.
What the hell, Fatimax death? Lol, spit or swallow?
A good girl knows the answer to that question.
I will say the same thing that my mother said to me. A lady doesn't spit. It's not polite. And that is all I will say to that.
Kitten Attack actually put a very methodical reason on there if the guy has not been eating his pineapple. But we'll share that for another day. What the f-
I know much more interesting things to do with a pineapple.
That was a great thing you said to do with the pineapple.
I thought so.
Mm-hmm. Keeping that in my playbook for a later date. Okay, what am I doing wrong?
Along with the adult slip and slide.
That was amazing. Seriously, guys, the first conversation I ever have with this woman on Skype goes to, like, it really just kind of shows what kind of mindset we're both in and how much attention we need if the situation ever presents itself.
Now, what is it you're saying you're having a problem with?
I'm trying to get the freaking medallion, but I'm not-
Yeah, you have to be on the other side of the swamp to get
oh,
to the
really?
Medallion. The area where the thief is?
Yeah. Okay, so I have to-
You have to go
to light world
side
on that side?
Okay, you have to go to the light world and then switch the dark world on that side of the map.
Walk over,
and then use the mirror, and it brings you out by the, medallion.
Okay, isn't there a, I don't need that for this dungeon, so I can get that on my way out. But, isn't there, like, another, like, piece of heart in the, like, just sitting up on the ledge in the light world around here?
Yeah, same thing. You stay in this section of the swamp, and you go, it's in the upper right-hand corner of the screen.
Right, but it was under a pile of rocks. I already got that one. It's right over here. So I'm
upper right hand corner.
Hold on, let me warp out of it.
Yeah, stay in that upper.
Right. You're talking about up there. I've already been there.
Meh.
Waiting. Well. Okay.
And Domino said, "Shelby thinks her boobs look huge in the new Screw Attack video on YouTube."
I thought they were always big. So.
Yeah, Fanmax just says, "Look huge? Aren't they huge anyways?"
Oh, and you know what it is? I think it was the piece of heart where it was, where I just killed that vulture, so maybe I'm thinking about something else that isn't there. Well, that's enough. That's enough lollygagging! Nope. Time to the dungeon!
Yes, she's a girl.
Okay, there you go. I just saw that. I just ran headfirst into a cactus.
Wait!
Way to effing go. Alright, let's do this.
Oh, my brain needs to stop.
Don't stop her now.
To a cactus instead of going, so that reminds you of that one girl that you dated that didn't shave?
Oh, God. Complications of intimacy on levels you guys don't even understand.
You don't understand.
No, seriously. Girls, if you're not shaving down there, why? Anyways. Alright, so here's one of the two places in the game where you need one of the two medallions. Just gonna go up here and you're just gonna wing, wing! Oh, that special effect's so cool. Love that. And see? You equalized the weather. Now, if you don't have enough magic here, you're kind of screwed, so.
Kill Ollie and I were having conversations about stripper heels.
What?
Stripper
Ooh. Guilds. Is that
no,
what you
heels.
Oh.
Anyway,
are those
yeah,
like
no,
are those like FMBs?
No.
You know what an FMB is, right?
Fuck me boots.
Okay, yeah.
I had those. Anyways.
Had?
Yeah.
Why had? Why is it past tense?
Anyways.
Return of the Wiz Robes, one of my favorite enemies.
Anyways, so I put earlier, which I'm surprised you didn't find this, but I said dancing around the apartment in stripper heels. Why? Because I fucking can. And Kaylali replied back, she goes, when I get to a higher level of pole dancing, it's compulsory to dance in high heels.
Nice.
And then Jackal,
uh-oh.
He said, tape it and send it to my email.
Yeah, I don't think that's gonna happen.
No, Jack, let's not. I know he's in the chat.
And you know, I remember seeing Kaylali say something along those lines, but I was in the middle of my routine of changing the cat litter. So it was just one of those, I hear the message, but I don't get a chance to check the message. But that would have been cool.
Yeah.
Oh, no, how big are they? Are they like more than 3 inches?
Maybe.
Nice. Does it have a fairly big platform on it, or is it just all heel?
It's got a slight platform. It's not like the huge ass, like the.
I was gonna say, don't kill yourself on them.
Yeah. No.
There's an art to picking out high heels, guys. You know, if you ever have to go shopping with your girlfriend with it, you'll figure it out real fast. Remember, she needs to be able to walk in them. That is the important thing.
Actually, it's really funny that there's an actual, like, a Karma Sutra move called the Gamer, which involves heels.
Running time! Oh, of course I find the treasure chest without the key. The hell is wrong with me? Wait, it's called the Gamer's Heel?
No, I said it's called the Gamer.
Oh, it's called the Gamer.
And it's all heels.
Ah.
Because you use them like controllers.
Oh. Analog sticks, I get it. That's hot.
I thought so.
Yes.
I was impressed they actually, like, put in,
I don't know why I put that second bomb down. There's no bombable walls that aren't in the center of walls. Whatever.
Psychosis?
What did psychosis say? Hey! Anonymity is a good thing, sir.
Guys, shh.
Please.
Awesome, PC user. Hey guys, I'm here after playing Team Fortress 2 with other G1s and G1 After Dark.
Tell those guys in After Dark to get in here. This is important. This is serious business because it's linked to
the past.
They're
apparently doing like a 48-hour stream.
Oh.
To kind of promote SGC.
Well, that's, you know, I don't want to put my hipster glasses on or anything, but me and Shelby were doing the awareness streams before it was cool. 19 hours, but you know, if they're doing it for 24, then, you know, that's good because we need everything that we can get our hands on.
No psychosis, Jared finally was trying to stay incognito. That's why I went, shh.
Welcome, Jared. How goes your Friday night, sir?
I think he's probably still staring at the last story.
Oh, about the gamer?
Eternal debate to open or not to open.
Oh, yeah, seriously. Because it's been like one of those things like, we've waited this long for it to get here, and it's one of those things that what if I open it's not, it doesn't meet my expectations. Rah, 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 rah. I know exactly what you mean.
Is that looking for a weekend release, Jared? He just mentioned that he's been editing the next Bro Review.
Oh, nice. Yeah. I do remember him making mention of that earlier. Oh, that's right. It was these guys who could detonate the bombs with the hookshot. See, yeah. It was like I was remembering, like, I can do that, but it's like, I can't. It's those other bombs.
Yeah.
Sprinkle. Yeah.
I just understand Hit how bombs. A slug lays a bomb.
Video game logic.
That's awesome, Jared. Hopefully he's gonna put the new Pro Review out tonight.
Oh, that's fantastic!
Yeah, Phantom X-Dead. He goes, we Canadians have to wait an extra week for Last Story.
Well then, you know, it'll hopefully be everything that we all wanted
Domino,
it to be.
Don't ask for clues. Don't spoil.
Yeah, don't ruin things. Key! Stab you to death. You know what that really drove me crazy? You know what grinds my gears, Kelly? is that you get the mirror shield and it doesn't reflect the magic from the lasers from those yep. statues. It wasn't even until, I don't even think it was Link's Awakening. I think it was Ocarina of Time was the first game that actually let you do that. I do remember the mirror shield in Link's Awakening reflecting, it was like fire from like some angry fire-breathing wall trap inside of one of the mountaintop caves towards the end of the game. I would very much like to do Link's Awakening, but I want to get the Elgato first because I want to get it on Game Boy Color because I haven't played the DX version. That came out at a time where I just didn't have the Weepy tier?
No, I said Bunny.
Oh, Yak. We call when I was a wee one, we called that Bunny Rabbit at top speed because for some reason your running animation looked like you're going quicker than you really were, which wasn't the case, but you know, it was 10. Give me a break.
Oh, and that's actually awesome. Mentioned his last pro review was 3 weeks ago, so this is a new record for him putting a new one.
Hey, okay, stop. Seriously.
Tom, keep playing the game.
No, I will gladly give up those precious few seconds for Race to the Finish for that. I will, you know, that's a deserving of a Citizen Kane clap. Because,
That bee is the deadliest bunny. No, it's not! It does sweet dick all! It just runs around!
No, so I had, you know, doing what I have been dabbling that has not seen the light of the internet yet, and this right here, I have a whole new appreciation for what people do. You can't go through doors when you're a rabbit, really? I have a whole new appreciation for what internet content...
yes. You want badass bunny. I thought bunnies were good at going down the hole.
Oh, giggity giggity goo.
Ah, really, dude?
Hey, you're talking about bunnies and holes, and we know what rabbits do. Whatever comes naturally.
They eat carrots, and they go in the rabbit hole, and they also fuck an incredible amount.
Yes. Oh, speaking of which, the landlady...
I'm sorry. I just like how it just, like, you know, talking about rabbits fucking. Speaking of which...
No, there's, the landlady was trimming her, the garden she had up in the front of the house, and she saw a bunny this big. It was just like, it's a baby bunny!
I'm sorry, I'm just laughing at the fact of fuck like rabbits. By the way!
Speaking of which, I'm like the guy from the Rage comics that just drops in. By the way, BTW.
Cribbin says rabbits like to cross-dress and make retarded actors want to fuck them. Actually, one of my favorite Looney Tunes was the opera.
Oh, right, Bugs Bunny, right.
No, yeah, but the Bugs Bunny, the opera one.
Oh, right, yes. Yeah. Killed a rabbit.
Elmer's not retarded.
Really? News to me. Alright.
Mal said, when I first played this game, I completely missed the Moon Pearl and got the first... thought that was normal.
Dear God. So, like, you beat Eggman and you go to the Dark World and then all of a sudden... your host.
That's funny, and I can't do nothing.
Hilarity ensues. I remember those bastards taking up a retarded amount of damage. Fuck.
No, Ember's just slow. Really slow.
There is actually, if you want a
tinted window licker special.
If you want a funny bit of, like, backwards irony, there is a, and it's extremely, extremely racist, but Warner Brothers put out a Bugs Bunny cartoon in the 40s that had a really bad caricature of a African American going after Bugs. You can find it on YouTube, but the funny thing about it is, and this is, like I said, it's progressive in a really ass-backward kind of way, this guy came closer than anybody had ever had in Bugs Bunny's history of being chased by people to getting him. Like, I'm talking, like, ready to get skinned and turned into soup. I was like, holy crap!
Anyways, Mal said, I thought you get the Moon Pearl in the Dark East Palace.
Oh boy. I guess somebody was not having fun with those little puzzles where you had to drop down from above. Of course it's tiles. It's always tiles. Yeah! Can't remember. Why did I go and light that stuff when I... Because I'm a genius like that, that's why. You know what, F it.
Animex says, yay, my pickups video finished uploading on YouTube. Probably should post it on ScrewTag now. Fuck its shitty quality. Pickups video?
Pickups? Unless if he's talking about, like, for his guitar. But then again, I didn't know he played guitar. You got the compass! Something I don't need!
Yeah, really.
You can burn skeletons, because that makes sense for some reason. Wait, what? I killed the guy, the door closes. What? That doesn't make sense at all. Right. Okay.
Skrua says, I beat Ozma when I was 9 in Final Fantasy 9, and I haven't been able to do it since then.
Well, that's a drag, dude.
I know. That fight sucked balls.
Just a little bit.
It was awesome, but it sucked so bad at the same time.
I remember the hardest boss fight that I ever did back in the mid-90s was fighting Culix.
Yeah,
and level, even at level 30, Culix was just a nightmare.
I really had no problem with him.
Well, that, again, you're just better than me.
Yeah, we know that, but I just like...
I know, this has been well established and documented, but it's just one of those things that just...
Do it. Anna says, pickups is what people call retro hunting finds.
Oh, pickups, I get it.
Value Village, nice.
Yeah, no, I put a video up on my, well, not a video, a photo up on my Facebook of the TurboGrafx 16 that I got and all the games that I got along with it. A lot of them were still sealed in the box. Very proud of those, so if anybody can find me a Turbo Booster or Turbo Booster Plus for the TurboGrafx that's not $300.
I need to go and tweet that to Gar and see if they've got that at ANC Games, because when I was there, I wasn't allowed in the store, like when ABGM was doing his signings and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
God damn! Wow, Muda. He goes, I thought pickups are what Kanan's boyfriends are. Ouch, sir.
Dude, she goes to the bar and she brings home whatever the buck she wants.
We've had this story. Kanan doesn't like the whole, hey, let's go pick up something from the bar. No.
Well, it didn't end well that one time. That doesn't mean it's gonna just be like that every time.
I just, at that point, I'm just like, I really don't want to pick up the to-go menu.
Carryout's not what it used to be.
No, takeout, the service isn't what it used to be.
Mm-hmm.
Mood said, I meant picking them up and throwing them around.
Yeah, throwing them across the room. So awesome. I would pay rap dollars for that.
Just because I launched my former boyfriend across the room onto the bed. Yeah.
It's amazing. It's amazing.
Dreamscape. Kaven's a classy lady. She only dates the men she loves and then eats them alive. I'm not a praying mantis!
Or a Black Widow.
Or a Black Widow. The Kanan.
You could be Black Widow!
No, I'm not dressing in something that tight.
Scarlett Johansson!
No.
Right meow.
No.
You know what, how about I get the freaking stupid cane that you technically don't need, I just realized. Because I don't think there's a spot in the game where you actually need that flipping cane, but I've got enough of a lead over Shelby that I can get it. Because otherwise it'll bug the crap out of me that I don't. Do you get a heart piece for fighting Agmin the second time?
I don't think so.
Oh, sugar. Really? Oh, well.
Yeah, if I remember correctly, as soon as you kill him, the bat flies to the pyramid.
Pyramid of power. Okay.
But it just confirmed that. He goes, nope.
Well, okay, then there's 6 more pieces of heart floating around there that I may or may not go for depending on how much time I have left. Speaking of which, what's my time count?
You have 50 minutes, sir.
50? Oh boy. Okay, barely enough time to Okay, got the stupid cane. Now let's go and do awesome things like beating the boss.
Not stupid cane, it's useful.
No, it's cane, not cane.
No, I said it. Nah, the cane is not stupid. It's useful. I didn't say myself.
Yeah.
I know I'm damn useful.
Oh boy, is she ever.
Shut your mouth.
Nah.
The Legacy of Kanan.
Yes, I would pay. I would play that. I would play that.
No.
Because it would be like Devil May Cry. You'd just be like drinking all the time and then throwing men around. It's like that. It'll be the constant game of like you getting hit on at bars and like I just want to get drunk. Leave me alone and start just throwing people everywhere.
Yeah, with the exception of I don't get drunk. We've had this conversation.
You've gotten. No, you haven't. Okay, never mind.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. I forgot you could do that. S a D.
Dreamscape Kane is actually useful. If it wasn't for her, I wouldn't be able to open pickle jars.
What does that even mean?
Jared says, "What a terrible life Kane has. So many men she has to throw them around."
Kane and her knock around, guys. That's exactly what it is.
Oh, Jesus.
Rah, rah!
Well, go rah, do weightlifting, Escape. He said I lack upper body strength. Go do weightlifting. That's actually quite fun.
I'm stuck. Oh, there we go. See, almost had another glitch video. Oh, it's because the candles went out. Okay, well that makes sense. That would explain things.
Blaven just said, Legend of Tom, a cane into the past. Fuck no, I'm a hero. I'd have to rescue Tom's ass.
Pretty much.
I'm just putting that out there. If anybody's wearing the tunic, it's me. Although I'd be wearing pants.
No.
Yes.
No.
Oh, yes. Oh, God.
I killed him as a bunny. There you go.
Anyways, what was it? The con pictures that are on Screw Attack. There is a girl dressed as Zelda, or not Zelda, as Link, and I'm looking at the tunic going, I really hope to fucking god this girl's wearing shorts, because that tunic is incredibly fucking short, like that just barely covers the lady parts. I'm like,
that's the idea. And you know what, I've seen, you know, funny story, I have seen skirts that short, but they're really not so much skirts anymore as they are belts. There we go, now we're getting somewhere. Because my memory be hazy, because it's been so long.
Mal, do you really have to think about that? Because Mal's like, Kanan gets the Triforce of Power. Tom gets the Triforce of Knowledge. Really?
I mean,
you put some of this shit out of this man's mouth. Do you really think he's got the Triforce of Knowledge?
I think you're talking about the Triforce of Wisdom, so maybe I do, because I remember the lore. Just saying.
Uh-huh. I'll put...
Oh, that's right. Okay, maybe you actually do need the cane to finish this dungeon. Because you gotta pick up the stupid...
Mal says, whatever, Tom. Kanan has all three. Damn right!
She's gone mad with power!
Nuh-uh. I would be a fair and just ruler, and if you stepped out of line, I would torch your ass.
Would you rule over your people fairly with a shotgun?
I wonder if you could take the fire rod and fire it behind your back without looking.
Yes, yes, yes.
That would be badass.
Show you true strength! One-handed shotgun look behind the back out of 10. That's still my favorite one.
Yep.
That's good stuff, Jared. I'm still talking about that one.
Mal, draw that picture, please.
That picture.
Dreamscape says Kanan has the power of three goddesses. Well, it's the end of the world. I said I'd be a fair and just ruler, just don't step out of line.
Will you save us from Snooki's baby?
God. The troll baby.
You know, just like watch it, like it's gonna be the most beautiful baby and this child's gonna do everything the right way, like it won't be anything like her.
But actually the funny thing is, Snooki's actually really intelligent. She has several university degrees.
What?
One of Yeah, one of my friends.
Well, she doesn't act like it at all, and the crap that she said about not changing diapers and crap.
Anyways, let me finish. One of my friends actually met her in real life, and she's like, she's fucking brilliant. Like, talking to her.
So she's playing a character on the Jersey Shore, is what you're saying?
Exactly. The Jersey Shore is not anything. It's all scripted. It's already been proven that that's scripted.
The stuff that I hear on the radio about the situation is, I'm just wondering how much of that is really him, because if he's really that dumb and he's really letting his brother run his business, then he is every bit as stupid as he is on TV as he is in real life.
Yeah, and I think that one JWoww or whatever her name is.
The one that pees in the bushes based on what Jenna Marbles was saying on her last video.
And I'm packing a dress because I'm a fucking lady.
Yeah.
I love her videos.
What if
so
they don't
much?
Have books? There was this one that Shelby showed me the other day.
They don't have chairs.
Yeah.
Chairs?
Yeah. There's this one, it's not Jenna, but, like, it's Jenna material, like, quality material that, talking about resealable tampons. And it was just, like, the stuff that she was talking about was, like, oh my god, Jenna needs to talk about this, because it is going to be effing great, and I need to flip the switch. God damn it. Get back down the stairs.
What Blademan says, Tom, you know Tycho is going to cosplay as the fruit fucker?
He is? When did this happen? Because I know they had their Kickstarter just wrap up, which I'm conflicted about that. The whole premise of their Kickstarter is to raise money to take ads off the site. They worked so hard to get those ads, and they're just gonna suddenly turn it away? I don't know. The businessman in me is just not understanding that. Maybe I won't understand until I have that level of connection with the audience that they do, but whatever. Oh, that's right, it's this guy. Rah! Rah! Rah!
What the hell?
Are you constipated?
Do you need medicine?
Jeebus, that lightning hurts. Holy crap.
Lightning does tend to sting a little.
I'd like to point out that this is another boss where I have full health, and my zap bolts don't do any damage, so just as to that point, yes.
Psychos is mentioning to, again, both of us. He goes, do you guys wish to join us for M versus M after? I don't have the computer to do it, Psychosis. Maybe. I don't.
That is a definite maybe, depending on what people want to do after my 2 hours is up. If we want to, like...
Anyways,
crap!
Tom.
Hi.
Jared says, it's more than the ads. If they don't have ads, they also don't need to do work for outside companies, like comics or art publishers. They'd rather spend that energy doing stuff they think the audience would like.
Oh, see, I didn't know they were doing stuff for other people.
Yeah.
Because I remember... they had a pretty successful ad campaign for the ESRB a couple years ago. I remember seeing posts in Game Informer and stuff like that. So, if that's what they're looking to do, looking at my internet usage and everything is A-okay. So yeah, I think the era of dropped frames and crap is behind us. 21 viewers, it's fantastic. Let's keep going. What's my time?
Nate Graves just went, I learned something today. Lightning hurts. 41 minutes.
Lightning does hurt, yes.
And Jared said they've done a lot of Ubisoft comics, Assassin's Creed, Splinter Cell, Prince of Persia, etc.
I remember the Splinter Cell one.
I've seen that. I've seen the Assassin's Creed.
Which came with the Splinter Cell Chaos Theory Special Edition. It was hilarious because they were talking about When doing the human ladder, think of manly things like monster trucks and everything, and do a firm handshake when you're for a job well done, trying to avoid any homoeroticism. And I was like, that's hilarious. I also remember them doing a lot of the comics for Brothers in Arms as well. I remember that was being like one of the pre-order bonuses. But it was funny because it was like their art style that you know from Penny Arcade, but it was done in a serious wartime style. It was just funny like that. It's like, I shot until I ran out of bullets, and then I pulled up my bayonet and I let them all have it. Mom, forgive me. And I'm like, wow, this is... Yeah, ravens, get out of here. Ravens! Okay, isn't there like a Dark World portal around here?
Oh, nice. Scro says, my money for SGC is hitting my account next week.
Excellent.
I sold my gaming desktop that I wasn't using.
Oh, that's a pretty big cause, dude.
He also pledged.
Good. Yes, guys, we're seeing more movement on the pledges these last... This week, more so than we have the other time that this has been going on. So please, keep at it. I want to see this happen. You don't understand how much fun and what it means to me and little Kurt Wilkinson. You've seen him in the videos, the little dude in the wheelchair. I felt bad that SGC didn't happen. I felt even worse for Kurt that SGC wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, we know we're up to 49k now, which is great.
I know, that's really wonderful, because really I woke up this morning and it was 48,000 and I did the tweet about that.
No, we're not past the 50k mark yet, Mega Silver.
We're getting there. Baby steps.
I just wish they would have... Like, I know Craig's still on the phone about trying to get the whole PayPal thing squared away. So
I thought he had that squared away.
I thought so too. Oops. But then he made mention on Screen Around this week that he's still working on that. So.
Well, there's a temporary stopgap measure for that. If you guys want to donate, put a pledge up there, and you do not have a valid credit card and you feel that PayPal's the only way you can be able to do that, go to your local 7-Eleven, your bank, somebody that sells those prepaid Visa and American Express cards, and you can do that. Now, one word of warning, they're not refundable. So when you buy them and say worst case scenario happens, you're gonna have that money on that card. So just be prepared to use that instead of the whatever amount you want to pledge. But it does work. Because I had a bunch of people, it's like, oh, I want to buy Microsoft points on Xbox Live. This is before we were selling them in stores. What do I do that? It's like, buy one of them prepaid cards at the 7-Eleven down the street. Like, oh, Tom, really? That's awesome, dude. Here we go, Babombos. Watch this. Look at this. This vulture's totally going to get exploded. Ha ha! I created fireworks. Yay, a medallion I don't need, but I got it because I want it. Okay. Right.
I love that medallion so much.
Oh, dude, the S that you can cause with it is just brilliant.
Oh, yeah. The dungeon that you just completed, I actually used that one quite a bit. It's like, oh, Wizrobes, really?
Yeah, just set the whole room up. Oh, look at that, I have all the equipment. Well, how about that? Isn't that something? Zip, zop, zoop, and bop. Cosby sweater.
No.
Evil shenanigans. The Turtle Rock. Whoa, what was that?
Shiro says, I hate that yellow hat.
Yeah, it's not...
I like this set. Bleh. I don't like the red colors.
I prefer the
red. I like the red tunic, but the hat, like, what, the purple hat? Like, no.
Purple's the color of royalty.
Man, you're a royal pain in my ass.
Then that means I'm doing it wrong. So, let me try again.
No. I really do hope this happens. I really want to go.
You and me and a whole bunch of other people.
Well, the thing is, like, you actually got to experience 2 years of SGC. I've never had SGC, so it's like, it would mean a whole lot if I actually did get to go.
Yes.
Purple is the color of swag. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm not taking that. Fuck your couch.
F your couch. Charlie Murphy. Wait, is it before Turtle Rock or after Turtle Rock that I can get the bomb shop?
After,
so really it's the last dungeon?
Like, well, the bomb shop's there. He just doesn't sell the big bomb until after you've beaten a Ganon.
Beat Ganon or beat Turtle Rock?
Beat a Ganim.
Agmon, okay. Dang, it's right at the very end of the game, too. That's too bad. Right when it matters the least.
Psychosis, Team Dark Blue.
God damn it.
So in other words, you're Team Brian.
Team Guest.
No.
How did Link win the basketball game? He used his hookshot. That was actually a joke that was sent into Nintendo Power.
I know, and you gave me a headache with that, because you've used that joke before, and it's
yeah,
still
but,
bad.
But now I actually get to use it in the context of the game. Fine, don't give me any rupees, you
wussies. That's the psychosis, yes, Cyan, but he used the dark blue when he was doing Mario Party. The light blue, the baby blue, is what, Lauren used. Yes, Jared, Craig is never going to be on Mario Party After Dark, so he has no team. Because, Psychosis went, Brian is team Cyan, light blue, and dark blue is team Craig.
Yeah, if Craig ever actually does do it, it probably won't ever.
He has stated on more than, like, several occasions that he has no intent.
And he also said at one point in time the hat wasn't going to come off either, but it did, and now it's come off multiple occasions, so, you know, it's one of those things you never know! I don't think it'll happen.
So I said to Jared, he goes, Jared, we know, and why not just be a good person and support Craig? He goes, because I'm not a good person. I call a lie on that one, Jared. That's a lie.
No, it's, if Craig ever does do it, it would be an event like SGC or something like that. But no, then again, there are other celebrity personalities that they would like to see on the couch. I know everybody wants to see James Rolfe get on there, but I think that would be exhausting for him to...
I'm still rooting to see Sky Diddy on Mario Party After Dark. He even said that to me the other day. He goes, I'm still trying to get on Mario Party After Dark with you guys.
Well, it would be nice if he actually showed up in the chat. Jeebus, man.
He does actually, he watches the archives of them, though.
Yeah, but it's not the same. I mean, if you're gonna be there, be there. You know, say at least drop us a line saying, hey, I couldn't make it, you know. Don't leave us hanging.
But
Skylar's a nice guy, but I mean, just
well, no offense, he has no real obligation to sit in. Like, he's still cheering and everything like that, but, like, I know for a fact that one of the reasons he didn't come to one of the Mario parties was because he went to Florida to meet up with a fan at Disney World for the kid's birthday.
Nice.
Yeah.
Oh, speaking of which, Christy Pride.
Go vote for her to be a frag doll.
Yeah, I've actually played with the frag dolls on numerous occasions at the GameStop managers conferences, and oh my god, you guys don't even know. Like, their skill is not natural. It's like, and they were playing Halo 2. They're sponsored by Ubisoft. They were, because
yeah,
there wasn't.
They actually are legit gamers.
Yes, and the thing is, there wasn't a new Rainbow Six or Ghost Recon out that year, which is what they usually parade them out to play. But they were ripping us a new one at Conference 04 and 05 with Halo 2. And then when Vegas came out in 06, they pretty much set us all on fire with gasoline and laughed.
I don't know. I've just never been one for FPS games.
You know what? Not all are created equal, and not are all the same. I'm not saying that there is one out there for you, but you can't write off the whole genre, because I know some people that absolutely love Halo, but they can't stand Call of Duty.
No, like, dude, I have actually legit played a bunch. I used
and
to
I'm
play
not downing
SOCOM.
It.
I'm just saying, I used to play SOCOM and stuff.
SOCOM's third person.
But I'm just saying, I've played SOCOM games, I've played other first-person games. I know that's third-person, but again, for just shooting in general, I've played SOCOM, I've played...
SOCOM, boys!
I've played Halo. I just never really caught on.
Whoops, is it this one? No. This one? Yeah, there we go. Okay.
It's not that I don't like, it's just I'm not good at them.
Practice makes awesome.
Yeah, but I could be playing other games.
And that's how you never branch out into new genres, like, oh...
See, man, you fuck your couch.
Man.
I am more diverse than you are. You shut your pie hole.
Diverse?
With gaming.
Elaborate.
No.
No!
Nope.
And that sounds like a very hollow argument, m'lady.
Mm-hmm.
And what?
Amuna says, you play beat-em-ups, Kanan.
There's nothing wrong with beat-em-ups.
No, he said to me, do you play beat-em-ups?
Oh. The way you read it, it's like, you play beat-em-ups, kid. It's like, wait, how is that a bad thing? Skill, you see that? I did that on purpose. Ah! Damn it.
Nate Graves. Kelly, why do you want people to fornicate with their furniture?
That's her thing. It's her kink. She gets off on it.
Not really.
She's object sexual. She's not attracted to genders. She's attracted to furniture.
Dude!
Okay, what am I doing wrong?
You're not hitting them in order.
Yeah, which order is it? Because I'm not remembering it. Meanwhile, Jared's probably throwing his hands in the air. It's like, it's clockwise! Or something like that.
It's right, top, then left.
Right, top, then left. Okay, gotcha.
Because as soon as it makes the bad noise, you know that's not the one you're supposed to be hitting.
Right, I know. Okay. Get out of here. Damn it, Beavis. There we go. Two. You think out of all the... There's only, what, 9 possible ways to do that, and yet I screwed it up 6-7 times already. So... And here's the other medallion that you need to use. Like I said, you don't need the Babandos, but I did it anyway because I can. Look at that transitional effect!
I believe Shelby's at work this evening, that's
yes,
why.
Yes, she's working tonight. Otherwise, we would be playing Battle Kid, but...
No, you wouldn't. You'd be doing this one because you guys have been doing your race to the finish.
Yeah, but she, you know, she took a break in the middle of it, too.
Technically not. It's just she streams more than you do. Well, she still streamed Link on her day.
Oh, man, you actually do need the Cane of Samara. I forgot about this.
Mm-hmm.
Whoopsie daisy. Whoopsie daisy! It's good and broke now!
Way to go.
Eh.
I told you needed it for Turtle Rock.
Yeah, I thought it was another one of those switch puzzles, but no, it's this whole thing. Do you have the medicine of magic? I've got something better than that. I got the medicine of cure everything.
So basically, if you really think about it, you've got your green potion, you've got your red potion, you're drinking blue potion. So, are you drinking liquid Viagra?
It's what
you... It boosts everything.
If the sword stays tempered for more than 4 hours, please consult the doctor.
Not so much tempered, but I mean, you are shooting lasers with it.
Shooting freaking laser beams out of my sword.
So you can shoot your sword with power?
So you can shoot your sword with power, and when you're feeling down, a fairy will come around. Oh, god damn it. It's one of these Mira rooms.
Mira said no, he's drinking toilet cleaner.
Step off screen and go back on screen and then... Hey.
Ooh.
Oh, damn it.
Did you see Brent's new Bioshock video?
I was throwing my hands up in the air and cheering on the whole way. That, like, his two best ones that he's put out this year, Thief and Bioshock. What?
Thief last year.
Thief? No, Thief was this year. Cause he did he debuted it at MAGFest and he didn't put the video out until a couple of months later. Cause he asked me, it's like, oh god damn it.
I don't know. I really like the little Nemo one.
Yeah, with his nephew.
Yeah. Oh, Jackson's adorable.
Mm-hmm. Bioshock was great, especially at the end when he was doing the whole spelling out Rapture, and I was like, oh my god, this is so good! Skill.
Mm-hmm.
Great flipping song. Can't wait to get that whenever the next album comes out. Oh, for fuck's sake!
Oh my god, you swore on air! World's coming to an end.
I got mad.
No shit, Sherlock.
Spoken like a true... Wait, what part of the country are you from again?
East Coast.
No, you said like Maritime.
Yeah, Maritimer.
Yeah, there you go. That thing.
That thing. Oh, I'm a thing now?
F. F, F, F,
F. F. I am not a thing.
You are not a thing, you're Kanan.
Damn right. LS Dreamscape. There! Fucking done! After 4 hours, the blog is done! Peace user. Kittens!
What the... Yeah, kittens. What... Oh my god.
Kanan is an AI.
No, she's not! How dare you! That's a mean thing to say.
That's a mean thing to say.
It is! You should,
that's
like...
That's a mean thing to say, and you're a mean person for it!
Yeah. Lunchtime fail real hard. Again!
Tom, stop sucking. Yes, Dreamscape, go get yourself some food, dear.
Somebody go get Josh Niss and tell him to come in here. You're sucking. Stop sucking.
I'm surprised John must be working tonight, because normally he doesn't miss your stream.
Yeah, no, he texted me earlier today saying he was writing another Rockumentary episode, and was wondering if I was looking for anything, because he has a friend who's runs an independent video game store, and he was wondering if he wanted me to keep, he wanted an eye kept out for certain TurboGrafx games. So, oh, for fuck's sake. I apologize to everybody watching right now. This shouldn't be this hard, and yet I'm constantly effing it up here. You know what? This may actually decide whether Shelby catches up to me now, because I've totally effed the bet on this.
You're short on magic power.
Again. Oh, great. Tiles. Here we go. I'm just gonna hang out up here.
I just thought it was nice, though, that John offered to possibly get me an Alice figure just because I made him his banner.
That is nice of him, yeah. John's a really, really nice guy.
Yeah, Jared said, the guy who runs that store was my old boss at GameStop. He also appeared in name tags. Was he the DM?
The district manager? And speaking of which, the part of that, in that part in name tags, when he kept getting Dom's name wrong, that is so true. Those district managers can never remember what the third key's name is because they're never around enough. I was doing this, oh my god, that's so true!
Psychosis, you will see when he puts the video up.
It'll be ready when it's ready. All right.
No, people keep asking him, you know, what system or what game it is that he's pro reviewing.
I've stated my guess on numerous occasions. We'll find out soon to see if I was right or not. It's become a game. Hey.
I'm just putting my guess out there.
No, that's what my guess was. I thought you were just.
I put that out there too.
Oh, did you? Because that music. Ugh.
Yep.
I actually think I have it in my big drawer of doom.
When I was at the AVGN signing at AMC, that James was supposed to be there, but with the whole fuck up with the flight, they had a little shrine of AVGN stuff, and Heidelide was there. I was very tempted to just sneak that off and snap it.
You know, that's the really funny thing is, at any convention that James makes an appearance at, you will always find a huge row of vendors that are selling games prominently displayed of stuff that he's done with that year.
Well, like I said, in the pictures that I put on the blog, all these people, ANC Games had set up all these different games that James has done in the AVGN series, and it was funny actually seeing Predator there at the front.
And get the laser dog!
I was very upset.
Get the laser!
Two people got that reference.
Hey, it's Chain Chomp.
So upset with that. But, people couldn't even get past the first stage. It was hilarious.
Well, I think there's a certain someone in the chat that knows how to get that problem fixed.
Yeah, I know. But I'm just saying, it was actually kind of funny just, sitting and watching all these people try.
Got the stuff.
Phantom X Death. Jared's next pro review is obviously Predator.
That would be funny on a bunch of different levels, though highly unlikely. Just because it's, you know, it's... And I think people are going to be really disappointed that if should Predator 2 actually turn up on Terrible...
Jared went, no!
Oh, capital N-O, I turned my head.
Like it.
When you busted out the power glove and you actually threw that in, I was like, why are they doing this to themselves?
Because it's so bad.
Exactly. F your couch, Lucas.
Yeah, it will be on Teletubbies. I'm sorry, I still cannot get over how fast Chad
motherfucking James
snapped Elmo in just one shot.
That was pure rage.
That was just fan-fucking-tastic. Which also makes me wonder if he's going to do this with stuff with, like, you know, Kira being a baby. She's gonna have songs, your CDs, your games, and she's gonna play on repeat all the time. And I wonder if it's gonna drive him insane enough to snap it in front of his daughter.
I think he said something about Kira liking the sound of metal.
Yes, like, good baby.
Baby's yeah. Gonna, it's like, put on some...
Saying, it would be awesome.
Put on some Beatles while you're at it. Raise that kid, right? It's kind of important. And throw! Oh, god damn it. Damn it, Beavis.
Metal. And you have 18 minutes left.
Oh, crap. This does not bode well. What? Oh, man. Okay, I just found a way to check to see if those little portal things are in there. If you can't hookshot onto... Bunny rabbit.
Fan of Exorcist. The pawn shop I frequent has a copy of Elmo's Letter Adventure. Jared, want me to send you guys another copy?
How about not, and, you know, say they did or something? Because...
I think if you did that Fan of Exorcist, you might receive a pipe bomb in the mail, courtesy of Chad.
Lay yipes.
Open up, it's like, open up the parcel. Like, yeah, I got something from Screw Attack. This parcel will self-destruct in 10 seconds upon opening. Shit!
Like Chief Quimby, eh?
Yep. Poor Chief Quimby. Agent Kane says, Aerosmith and the Rocky Horror Picture are some of my least favorite things ever.
Aerosmith? I can understand that to a certain extent. Rocky Horror, I got nothing for you there, man. But then again, I don't like a lot of I can kind of relate to that, because while everybody I know loves,
it's just the jump to the left.
Huh? What?
It's just the jump to the left.
I get it. I got the joke. I was like, what? What did I miss? That's what I thought you meant.
Step to the right.
Yeah, but no, it's like everybody loves Mel Brooks' Spaceballs. I absolutely detest that movie. I don't understand why people think it's funny. It's like also the same reason why I don't think Will Ferrell's funny. Oh, F. Because you do like quadruple damage when you're a bunny rabbit.
And Vexa says, they'd send me Teletubbies in retaliation. Way worse than a pipe bomb. And Muda says, you don't like Spaceballs?
Nope. I've seen that movie. Like, the funniest...
But Muda doesn't agree with you on Will Ferrell. He's like, I don't think Will Ferrell is funny.
Yeah, no, here was what I thought the funniest part was in Spaceballs, and it really wasn't that funny of a movie. There's, like, some part where the Princess Leia knockoff gets, like, her hair singed, so she grabs Lone Star's rifle and just, like, lays waste to, like, 1,000 guys. And then he says, oh, not bad for a girl. And then Dot Matrix says, that's not bad for Rambo. If to me, that's the funniest line in the movie. There's a problem. It was just, like...
Matrix.
Huh?
Dot Matrix.
Yeah, that was the name of the 3PO ripoff. See, that's how much I dislike that movie, that I can remember stupid trivia like that.
But I like Dot Matrix from Reboot.
Matrix from Reboot's awesome. Dot Matrix from freaking Spaceballs is not... I don't care if it's voiced by Joan Rivers.
One of these days, I actually want to cosplay Andrea. I fucking love Andrea.
That would be cool.
You and bikes!
Yeah. Oh, whoops, wrong one. Watch your magic meter! Herp-a-derp! Never figured out what was supposed to be going on. Is he like, is it like sucked in like one of those?
Barrett apparently also likes Andrea.
Yeah, for good reason. No, it's like, what's up with those little things that you go into here? Is it like one of those tube systems that they see at a bank? Like when you go through the drive-thru or the old offices? Rah! Steph!
It just says it. I fucking loved it. Yeah, Bob was awesome.
Bob was awesome.
Yeah, Glitch, BFG. Still one of my favorite episodes.
Mm-hmm.
And it was neat, too, that in the movie My Two Bobs, they had the new voice actor of Bob, and then when they had the throwback Bob, they actually brought back the original voice actor for him. Mike the TV for $99.99.
Mike TV. The most important thing that we've ever learned, the most important thing we've learned as far as children are concerned. Bomb, 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 bomb. 10 minutes. 5 minutes. 3 minutes.
Yeah, I love the original voice actor too, Jared. You have 13 minutes, dude.
Lucky 13's the number that wins.
Yeah, like I said, I really did. I agree with you. I like how they worked that into the plot. I'm just disappointed that they never actually finished the movies. Like, it left on such a big fucking cliffhanger.
Well, there was, like, a bunch of shows back then that never got finished. You know, like, Pirates of Dark Water never got finished. But that was a fucking travesty.
But the thing was, though, it's like, they ended. They technically did end the series. But it was the whole, you know, they had this big super virus at the end, but they just, hey, let's end it on a musical note and wrap up everything. And then they brought the movies, which were also broken down into episodes for TV, which was supposed to be season 4 if they had the following for it again.
I should never leave it in the hands of if a following. But then again, I'm not those big shot producers that make those decisions.
Nice. Jared said, when I went and previewed Prototype 2, one of the guys I interviewed was originally an animator from Mainframe Entertainment, and he worked on Reboot Season 3 and 4.
Oh, really?
You nerded out a little on him. Dude, I would have done the same thing.
Kind of a big deal. I mean, yeah. That was like one of the best things that they had on ABC on Saturday morning.
I love the fact they actually made fun of ABC because where ABC canceled the show.
I love it when a show can get away with that.
Well, oh, yeah, it was end of season.
I'm listening.
No, I'm just trying to think. It was basically just before Bob gets thrown in the web. Like, remember when he and Megabyte, they all teamed up, and then obviously Megabyte betrayed them. They went, the ABCs, those dogs, they've betrayed us. That was making fun of ABC.
Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Frame rate.
The musical episode, like, well, the end of season 3 was fantastic. I loved that. Do not roll past this slide.
And
apparently when Jared was talking to this guy, he was slightly drunk. Drunk? Sir, never. I thought you could hold your liquor.
Must have been a lot of liquor then.
Damn right.
Liquor? I don't know her! Perhaps for the better. Effing hell. Hey, that was cool. Oh, god damn it.
Aww. Slaven never got to see the end of the series. Whoa, wait. Are you talking the end of what season? What was the last season you saw? Or Blademan. Yeah, Blademan said, I never saw the end of the series. And Ellis Dreamscapes, I don't even know what's happening anymore. Tom's still herpaderping through Link to the Past, and I am talking about Reboot because it's a fucking amazing series.
Yes. Oh, this looks familiar.
Jared, almost bored and trapped the event with Craig. Only thing left to do was drink. I probably have to agree with you on that. Aw, Dreamscape had a nap.
Every time, nap time! Stupid Hellemazar, get out of here.
Wow, yeah, Blade Man, that was midway through season 3. Blade Man, yes, when they found Bob in the web, that's where he left off at.
To web. If that's the case, he was indeed a very long way off.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I have insomnia too, Skrillex. I feel you on that. I do not like going to sleep at night.
It's where the bad people come together. She hates fighting the demons.
Actually, I like fighting the demons. I just hate when the fucking black phantoms invade my world and they fucking cheat and kill me.
Oh, man. Demon souls.
So good. So frustrating.
So good, yet so bad. Didn't want to do that. Wait. Okay, still have room for one more. Okie dokie. Stupid.
Yes, I hate the giant clams. Yeah, so annoying.
Giant clams?
You don't know. You do not understand.
Oh, she's pulling a Shelby.
No, you do not understand the fucking clams.
Apparently I don't.
I hate when you get summoned and you help somebody out and they don't fucking heal you.
I just realized I may have a problem. I don't know if I'm gonna have enough magic to kill the boss.
Muda said, I like Chad's please talk comment from last week's side-scrollers.
Huh? What was the comment?
No, that's what I was saying. I like Chad's police monster truck comment from last week.
Oh, okay.
And Psychosis said that I have to try a little bit of Daisy again. I still will be watching the stream.
Thank you.
I will be in the chat when I come back and raid. You know I died. Have fun with Daisy. Yeah, that would be kind of neat, PC user, if there was cross-platform between the PS3.
PS3 and what? Wait, what?
PC user says, I wish Dark Souls had cross-platform.
Oh.
So when I get the PC version of Dark Souls, I could play with y'all. I'm just excited that John said he's gonna go and re-pick up Dark Souls so he can play with me. That's gonna be awesome.
Yay!
Yeah, no, I really, like... If by some miracle you get enough money to come to MAGFest, I'm almost certain he's gonna try to make it down here this time. He is every bit as a nice person as you think he is, and then some. Like, seriously, it's just crazy.
I'd like to meet him. He's really.
Oh god,
super
yeah, seriously.
Give him a fucking high five and a hug.
Pretty much. And that's when the party just starts.
What, when I give a high five and a hug?
Yeah. Okay, so maybe I did have enough magic to do it after all. Oh! Oh, no, 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 no! F your couch.
Damn it, Psychosis! You haven't even gone for that long! I can't do anything, and I broke both legs! I can't do anything, I broke both legs, and I don't have any morphine! Well, if you offer to suck someone's dick, you might get some morphine.
Disregard zombies, acquire morphine. And catch it. Yay, save Zelda.
Yay!
Yeah, 215,000 frames encoded, not a single one dropped. Alright guys, here's some more exposition. Be able to get your speed reading goggles on. What's my time at?
6 minutes.
6 minutes! Enough time to go get some potions. You are already a legendary hero! Light World!
Wow.
I can't do lady voices, remember? Oh, that's right! You're supposed to read her part!
I know.